Continuing my earlier thoughts, it is my belief that we, the Scribe in the future, cannot prevent ourselves from dying off. We are now too static. Young beings have ideas that the old do not. I have observed our ward species, and, on occasion, for my amusement, even those not fit to become wards. The process a being goes through while becoming mature requires an intentional rejection of the old way of doing things. The young mind hungers to learn, to do things its own way. The Scribe do not have young minds anymore. We do not see new ways of doing things. As an illustration, the device I entered this report into is little changed from the one used 500 years ago. Unchanged because it is perfect? For reader, I assure you, it is not. My peers, the ones that understand the issue, are sanguine. They are content knowing we will one day be gone, and the more I think on it, the more I realize I am as well. A perfect end by a perfect race. We had seen the effects of evolution, the effects of exploration. It led to instability and suffering. Few know the truth of the Etraki War. I am not permitted to write of it here, but if we found one door that should not have been opened, why risk opening another? So, we stopped opening doors, and thus we are doomed. Our greatest concern now should be that of the fate of our ward species. They are young, full of life, and pathetic. For all their vigor, they will be doomed without us. How many trillions of deaths will occur without a Scribe to mind the tiller? This is what keeps me awake now.